Attention viewers, the male contestants in this program may be lying or misrepresenting themselves at all times, including in their interviews. This sweet, innocent Midwestern girl named Jackie is about to meet 14 men. Oh. She thinks she's going to find true love. But not all of the guys are here for romance. Some of them are gay.
What?
I shave my legs, so there's a definite possibility somebody may think I'm gay.
Some people may very well construe baking a cheesecake as being gay.
I am a straight man.
Everybody's gay but me.
He's like the biggest flamer I've ever met in my life.
If Jackie ends up picking a straight guy, she and he will each win $500,000. But if she falls for a gay guy, he will win the whole million, and she will walk away with nothing.
Every little thing I analyze that they do.
I don't think a gay man would kiss me.
You want to do it sitting or standing?
Oh my God, stop it.
She's trying to sniff out the gay guys.
What are your feminine qualities?
I'm not gay.
We're here for the money. I mean, we're all out for blood.
And I don't know which one of you is starting to spread little rumors or whatever.
That's a little bit much, I think.
Dude, I will bust your head open, all right?
It ain't over.
Come on, show on.
Oh.
Is that your shoulder?
My arm broke.
So in the end, will Jackie find true love? Or will she fall for a gay guy who'll win the whole million while she ends up with nothing but a broken heart?
It's not like they're in it for the love. I mean, they're gay. I have to know if you're gay or if you're straight.
Tonight, Jackie and the straight guys will find out the truth for the first time.
Oh my goodness.
How will the straight guys react when they find out there are gay guys here?
The gay people, they're openly gay, fine.
And how will she react when she finds out the truth?
It's so hard.
You know, it's actually a game now. She's got a lot of work on her hands.
Jackie, you freaked out.
You can't do this.
Handsome than the rest. He said we've come a woo, and Jackie will submit to any test. Oh, they came to sizzling saddles, but the thing she didn't know, some of these old rugged riders like a different rodeo. If Jackie wants to find a mate, she's gotta figure out playing it straight.
This beautiful girl named Jackie is about to leave her hometown in Wisconsin to travel to Sizzling Saddles Ranch to meet 14 handsome men who will try to win her heart. What she doesn't know yet is that some of these guys are gay. The gay guys know the twist, but none of them have any idea who else is gay. From now on, they have to play it straight at all times in order to deceive Jackie, each other, and you. Our host is about to tell all the guys the twist. For the gay guys, the way they react to the news will be the first test of how good they are at playing it straight.
Now, you're probably kind of wondering what this is all about.
Yeah.
Not all of you guys are who you appear to be. Some of you are straight, and some of you are gay.
What?
Wow. As in homosexual.
As in homosexual.
No.
Here lies the scandal.
How many people would you say are gay that are here?
I have absolutely no idea. So, if Jackie falls for a straight guy, they will split $1 million. But if she falls for a gay guy, he gets $1 million all to himself. She actually does not know this yet, so this is our secret for the moment. Question is, for all of you, eventually for Jackie, who is straight and who is gay.
I would consider myself a woman with small town values. I've always been raised to go to church and to always be polite, act like a lady, treat everyone how you want to be treated. I'm a fun girl, I'm down to earth, and you know, if I meet Mr. Right, then that's fantastic.
Gay people, they're openly gay, fine. You know what I'm saying? We're straight. How do they know how we feel about it? You know what I'm saying? They drop the bombshell on us.
The twist is, you know, the meat of it is whether or not that's worth $1 million.
Yeah, I was pretty pissed off. I mean, I gotta be honest. Probably my worst nightmare came true. Definitely not what I wanted to hear.
Having gay men around me, you don't really know how to react. I mean, you don't know if someone's watching, if someone's not. I mean, it freaks you out a little bit.
Oh, man.
Sometimes I make, you know, bad judgment in someone's character. When someone tells me something, I expect it to be the truth. And so I'm kind of a gullible person, I guess you could say that.
Let the best man win.
People kind of started to look over their shoulder and started to kind of look at each other and say, well, could he be? A lot of people, it got in their heads. We'll just have to see what happens.
When I first found out about gay people being in the house, it's like immediately you look around the room, you're kind of sizing people up right then and there, deciding, you know, who's possibly gay.
Some guys are a little bit more flamboyant than others, but you can't tell. Somebody could just be acting a certain way, or maybe, you know, I don't know who's gay.
Are you gay?
That's my thread. Are you good?
It's a good strategy.
No.
Well, somebody is.
I don't know what I'm getting myself into, but I'm sure whatever it is, I'll have fun. Right now, it's time for me to, you know, just get out of this small town and experience new things and hopefully meet the right guy.
Coming up.
Woo! Sizzling sales, here I come.
She knew that she was being deceived already and that some of these guys were gay, she would be pissed off.
I can't do this.
We basically just found out that some of the guys in the group are gay, and now to top it all off, we have to share rooms together.
It's like a stampede.
Damn it! What? Trying to find a room last night was kind of crazy. Everybody's so worried about, you know, being gay. You know, they're freaking out.
The whole process last night of getting rooms was pretty hectic. Just each man for himself.
When you're taking off your clothes or whatever, I know they're not gonna come up and like, you know, I'm gonna prey upon you, you know. They're not gonna do that. But yeah, it's a little awkward.
Hey, Alex, check it out. We got the one with the big patio.
Oh, man. It's pink. It's pink.
Good eye.
I got stuck with the big pink room. I was kind of like, oh great, people are gonna start thinking that I'm gay. Yeah.
Pink doesn't mean anything, it's just a color.
I am so excited about this experience, you know, because I love dating and I love everything that comes with it, you know, the flowers, the dinner dates. It's those little things that guys do that make me happy. I guess you could say I'm a hopeless romantic, you know, I'm looking for someone that's gonna sweep me off my feet.
Together. Everybody's scrambling at first to find the best room, and then suddenly we realize there's not enough beds, so now it's just a matter of getting a bed.
What's left is one bed, and there's two people left. It's Bill and it's Ryan.
This is me. This bed is just mine. That's all.
You don't know who's gay, who's straight, so why would you want to share a bed with someone that you don't know that answer to? I mean, you don't want to wake up with your roommate naked beside you. That just wouldn't make you feel comfortable.
I gotta have that bed.
No, you ain't gotta have nothing.
John and I both agree Bill's gay. I mean, the guy's on fire.
I can't sleep on this.
Well, then I'm supposed to?
I can't sleep on this bed.
Yeah, we'll talk about it.
No, I can't.
Bill sleeping in the same bed with me would definitely be crossing the line. I mean, this ain't happening.
Why?
No, here's the deal, because you can't just have the bed.
And what makes you get it?
Because we're going to flip a coin.
They're flipping right now to see who gets the bed. I guess that person takes the floor.
Heads or tails?
Heads.
For the bed, heads. Tails.
Bill took it really well. He wasn't upset.
This is my bed.
God, what an
Woo! Sizzling
Blazing Saddles Ranch, Jackie. You're definitely excited.
I'm so excited. Very much so.
Awesome. Well, let me tell you, 14 drop-dead gorgeous men from all across America are about to meet you and to woo you. You have to pick just one.
I can't have all.
All right, are you up for it?
Oh, yeah, for sure I'm up for it. Let's go.
Okay.
14 guys.
This is going to be tough, you know, eliminating and picking just one. I'm not a very good decision maker.
At this point, Jackie doesn't know some of the people in the house are gay. And I have a lot of effeminate qualities. So wow. I'm hoping that she doesn't start thinking twice.
Wow, this is great. I didn't expect this.
That's all up to you.
I think Jackie's going to have a really hard time figuring out who's gay and who's straight, because you could have some sort of feminine straight guys and some sort of, you know, really masculine gay guys. And I think I fall somewhere in the middle.
Some people may very well construe baking a cheesecake as being gay.
I enjoy decorating. I enjoy, you know, plants and, you know, landscaping.
I've thought of doing hair as a career.
I'm doing a lot of poetry.
Singing a lot of Spanish, you know, ballads and things like that.
Modeling, I've got a bunch of nice clothes. I dress well, have a pretty good sense of fashion.
A lot of people say you're like more in touch with your feminine side.
I do know some things about art.
I've just never been an athletic kind of person.
I have a lot of like, toiletries.
Personally, I don't think I act or there's anything about me that would make someone think that I'm gay.
I'm a little nervous about, you know, meeting the guys today. I don't really know what to expect.
Coming up.
It's amazing to watch the deception that is unfolding. It's going to be a blood battle.
We can't do this. I don't know.
Before we rode up to meet Jackie, it was extremely tense. Everybody's a bit on edge, because all of us obviously want to make a good impression upon her. At the same time, we all knew that there's a group of us that were gay, and she's completely clueless.
Waiting for the guys was probably the most nerve-wracking thing I've ever done. Like, I mean, I've been on dates, but like 14 guys, I am so nervous. My palms are sweating, and I was shaking in my boots.
Jackie.
Hi.
Hi. I'm Bradley.
Bradley, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
This is kind of cool, huh?
It is very cool. Are you excited? Cool.
I'm very excited.
Me
very
too.
Excited. Bradley, from the start, I just thought he was absolutely adorable. And I was just thinking, man, if all of them looked like that, bring them on. Let's go.
I forgot my lasso. I apologize.
Yeah.
Ryan, he's pissed a couple of people off. He's kind of a little troublemaker. But he's probably straight.
Nice to meet you.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Ryan.
Hi, Ryan.
Can you get a hug?
Yeah.
Women like confident men, but there is, in fact, a line between being confident and then being arrogant. I just tend to walk it better than most people.
I don't think she's gonna think I'm gay, because once I get to kiss her, then I'll have it wrapped around my finger.
Jackie?
Yes.
Luciano.
Pleasure Luciano, wow. I'm just gonna say it flat out. Luciano is hot.
I think Jackie's got gaydar. I think every straight woman does. You know, there's the look in the eye.
I'm Alex.
Nice to meet you, Alex.
There's the body language.
Hi, Jackie.
Hi.
It's Lewis. It's a pleasure to meet you.
Pleasure meeting you.
There's a whole lot of things that girls can just pick up on to tell if a guy's gay or not.
Hey, how are you, Jackie?
I'm doing great.
I'm Bill.
Hi,
nice
Bill.
To meet
pleasure
you.
To meet you.
You too.
Hey there. Sensitive, kind of wishy-washy, kind of a hopeless romantic type guy. I'm not gay, I'm straight. I could get some references if you guys would like.
My name is Gus.
Hi.
Look at you, Mom. Even more beautiful than I pictured, huh?
Aww.
How are you doing today?
I'm doing great.
I'm Lee.
So great. Hi, Lee. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Oh.
They said you were beautiful, and you are.
I really wasn't sure what the guys were gonna be like, but they are absolutely gorgeous.
So all the guys are standing there looking at Jackie, and she looks so happy, and I think every single one of us was thinking the same thing, and that was that if she knew that she was being deceived already and that some of these guys were gay, she would be pissed off.
Wow. No, not whoa. Not whoa, wow.
Hi, Jackie.
Hi.
I'm Eddie.
Pleasure to meet you, Eddie.
Hi, how are you doing?
Hi, doing great.
I'm John.
Hi, John. Pleasure to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too.
It's amazing to watch the deception that is unfolding in front of Jackie. It's going to be a blood battle.
Hey, Jackie.
Hi, how are you doing?
Nice to finally meet you.
Oh, thank you.
I'm Cherie.
Hi, Jackie.
Hi.
I'm Chad. Nice meeting
Chad.
You.
Chad, pleasure meeting you.
Howdy.
Howdy.
Nice to meet you. I'm Banks.
I'm Jackie.
Nice to meet you, Jackie. You don't want to be somebody you're not, but under these circumstances, you don't have much of a choice. So I felt a little bit out of my element, you know, slightly coming apart, it seems. But some would say that's endearing. Pleasure to meet you. Enjoy the gentleman.
Okay. Love the experience here so far. I can't wait for what's to come. Later, fellas.
Bye, Jackie.
Bye, Jackie. Bye, Jackie.
Jackie's got the cutest face. She's got the cutest dimples.
I think she's got great.
She's got nice everything.
Very supple.
This point of the competition, trying to figure out who's straight and who's gay is tough. I look at these guys and it's like, I don't know. I mean, it's gonna be up to Jackie. That's the bottom line.
She's got nice legs. I like thick legs.
No, listen to me.
She doesn't have like little skinny chicken legs.
I like chicken legs.
Are
okay. I like skinny. No,
I don't like chicken legs.
No, I like skinny little ankles.
I'm Cuban. I like big legs.
Skinny little ankles and a muscular calf. That's the best.
All right, stop.
Wait. Did y'all look at her rack whenever you were first coming up? Because she's like on that step. So you're like down here like this. And I was like talking to her. I was like, I've been looking forward to meeting you and you.
Hello!
Nice talking to you guys, but I gotta go.
How are y'all doing?
Holy Sarah, Jessica Parker.
When Jackie came out, the best way to describe it is a bunch of vultures just discovered a new carcass.
Hi. Oh, thank you. So I walk out and I'm totally overwhelmed with all the guys. They just kind of swarmed around me and they're throwing compliments and it was really charming. Hello, darling. Hello, I'm doing fantastic.
Jackie not knowing the twist was difficult.
I wanted her to know. I mean, it was killing me to keep that under my hat for the 24 hours we had to.
Here, you lead me. Where should I sit?
Oh, yeah, Bradley, yeah. Uh-huh.
At the barbecue, I just tried to take charge of Jackie because I wanted her to come sit at my table and make sure that she got a lot of, just kind of close time with me. Some of the other guys were sort of, just trying to sort of move in on her a little bit.
Yeah, look at that. I was prepared.
Here's to y'all. Cheers. Cheers. Cheers.
Cheers. Cheers.
There you go.
Gay or straight, everybody is deceiving her in some way, shape, or form. They're trying to make themselves to be more of what they are or less of what they aren't. It is a game.
It's a little surprise for me and the bartender. If you don't like it, you can always blame the bartender.
John's a bit of a He can be annoying at times. I don't know if he's trying too hard or if that's really who he is. And I initially thought there's no chance this guy's gay. But I'm thinking maybe it's just all one big cover-up.
I thought maybe there might be some competition, but you know what? All the guys are getting along just great.
Let's arm wrestle for her.
All the guys at my table were like, oh, well, she's been sitting with that table over there like through the whole dinner, and we really haven't even gotten to talk to her. And I'm like, well, then why don't we just go get her?
Oh, my goodness.
That's good.
How does it feel, though, just be like the only girl around?
This is great.
Pretty sure Jackie's going to be shocked right when she finds out what the competition is all about. You know, I was shocked.
I was basically in heaven. You know, it was like a dream. You know, all these guys surrounding me, asking the questions, and I was just excited to get to know them on a more personal level. Bye, boys.
Do you have any idea what course of the evening room is?
No, we pretty much figured out who's gay and who's not.
I don't know.
Have you?
Yeah, everybody but us in here.
I think both. Probably the gay guys that are in the house right now that you can kind of pick out are Ryan and Gus.
Definitely Bill. Definitely Gus. And definitely Chris.
Chad, Lee,
Chad and Alex.
Eddie and Ryan.
John.
Sharif and Banks.
I think Luciano might be gay.
Lewis.
Sharif, Alex, and Brad.
Coming up, Jackie's world is turned upside down.
Jackie, I need to tell you something very important. Some of these guys are gay.
I can't do this.
Jackie has no idea at this point what's going on. And the rest of the guys, we all know, and we are playing the game.
I wanted to say that I didn't really have much of a strategy. I wanted just to come here and just truly be myself, but
just realize that the small things you say, the insignificant things you say and do, can have a profound effect in the game.
You know, like this morning, Jackie came in and asked for a hairdryer.
The hairdryer story. Jackie said she needed a hairdryer, asking if any of the guys had one. Well, before I even really thought about what it would make me look like, I gave Jackie my hairdryer, and everybody kind of turned around, and I could tell that it were just like totally keeping score.
She's not gonna forget that. She's gonna find out this twist, and that hairdryer's gonna come up, and he was smacking himself in the head.
All I can say is poor boy.
To the fellas. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
There's 14 strapping young lads, and I don't want to just pick one. I want to have them all.
This isn't really that much of a game to her. You know, she's looking for someone to, you know, start dating and hopefully have a relationship with, and there are these guys here who are, you know, totally looking to hurt her.
I don't know. I'm a little lost. So.
Hey! Yay! There she is!
Look how beautiful she is.
She is
very beautiful.
Jackie, you've been having a lot of fun. I mean, how could you not enjoy 14 men courting you?
Yeah, we had a blast today.
Jackie, I need to tell you something very important.
Oh, my goodness.
Not all of these guys are who you think they are. Some of them are straight. And some of these guys are gay.
What?
You can see just through body language, she was kind of twitching a little bit, you know, her arms getting a little bit closer, just out of, you know, protection. Just a lot of doubt. You can see it was coming to her head, like, who can I trust, who can I not trust?
If you pick a straight guy to fall for, the two of you will split $1 million. If you fall for a gay guy, he gets the entire million himself, and you don't get anything.
When Daphne told me the twist, I was shocked. I couldn't believe that any of those guys were gay.
I don't feel bad at all that Jackie has been led on this long. She's right there in the boat with the rest of us.
Either you get love and a fortune, or you get heartbreak, nothing. And I have one more hard thing to tell
you. Okay.
That by the end of the night, you have to ask two of these guys to leave.
Tonight?
Enjoy the rest of your meal.
You know, I think she's probably looking at people a bit differently. It's actually a game now. She's got a lot of work on her hands.
I need another drink.
Yeah, they told us all yesterday.
Okay,
huh. It turns out the guys already knew the twist, and that just blew me away.
Imagine how all of us were. We were all freaking out, too.
We have to share rooms.
Yeah.
Yeah. They picked us because we're well-kept. We're, like, you know, into grooming, obviously. Hey, you promise you won't hold it against me that I loaned you my hair dryer?
Well, I was kind of wondering myself. I'm like, why does this guy with short hair have a blow dryer? But, hey, you know, whatever. I don't know how guys style their hair.
Back and I thought about the time we'd spent together, and you know, I have to rethink this and completely reevaluate everything.
Right now, she's trying to decipher who's who and what's what, because that, I mean, she didn't know before.
I just can't believe some of these guys are lying to me. It just really hurts. I don't know what I'm gonna do. So I'm just gonna keep sitting here and thinking about it.
Jackie only had about 20 minutes to digest the news about some of the guys being straight and some of the guys being gay before she found out and we found out that she would be calling the guys out to have a swing date.
The guys I chose for the swing date were Bradley, Ryan, and Gus.
You know, a lot's going through my head. I'm like, all right, she's gonna pick guys that she thinks are gay to see if they are or not, to see what they say, or maybe she picks the guy she likes the best to see what happens.
My strategy, you know, I've been thinking about it. I'm gonna just watch their mannerisms and see their personality, how they react towards me, see if we have some sort of connection, because I would really find it hard to believe that a gay guy can honestly act like he's straight.
Oh, what are your feminine qualities? Yeah. So tell me more about yourself.
What would you like to know?
Your hair dryer.
Oh,
what's the
come
deal, dude?
On,
what's
come
the deal?
On. I know.
You do not need a hair dryer.
I totally do, though.
My last relationship was a 3.5-year relationship.
So what are your interests?
I love working on cars.
I tell you, I have, like, feminine qualities. I know this. I've been told this, but I'm not gay.
That's... I'm on probation because of my hair dryer.
I'm trying to make you understand how important you realize it is that I'm not. I'm not gay.
Look how thick it is. Feel my hair.
Honey, you were the only guy with the blow dryer.
The hair dryer, she said that she was over it and that she got past it, but we'll see.
Right now, she's got to eliminate two people.
Who do you think she's going to eliminate first?
Sure, I think everybody's nervous about tonight. It's the night that we all dread because nobody wants to be kicked off.
What is it that's driving her? Is it the money, or does she genuinely want to meet somebody to fall in love with?
Nobody really knows what Jackie's thinking, if she really likes us and laughs at our jokes for real or not, so it's pretty stressful for everyone.
There is $500,000. Right now, she's thinking about the money.
So with my swing dates, it really helped me clear my mind and focus, but this is such a tough decision is to decide, you know, whether someone's gay or straight. This group that are deceiving me, and obviously, you know, it hurts so bad, you know, because I mean, it's not like they're in it for the love. I mean, they're gay, they're in it for the money. I walk up there standing next to Daphne, and I look at all the guys, and then I just look down immediately. I could not even look at any of the guys. It didn't matter if they were staying or not. It was awful. It sucked.
We're all sitting there, you know, and it was just, I think it was so much pressure. The tension between the guys was just like, you could cut a knife through it.
The two that are asked to leave, this is your opportunity to tell her the truth about yourself.
Well, fellas, this has been quite an evening for me, and tonight was so hard for me to try to decide who to eliminate because, I mean, you have your game face on. So let's get this started. Let's see. How about Banks?
I believe Banks is gay. First of all, he shaves everything, his arms and his legs, and I don't know any man that does that.
You know, when I came onto this, I knew it was gonna be an adventure. I just ask that you humor me in a couple more days, if you will.
I'm really looking forward to getting to know you more, so I'd like to ask you to stay. Is that all right?
How'd you be all right?
Oh. Okay. Eddie, darling, love the accent. You're absolutely hilarious. So you're staying. Mwah. All right, Sharif.
This is one big game, and all that I know is what I'm thinking and what I'm feeling and what I'm doing. But who knows what's going on in that pretty little head of hers?
Sharif, you know, I don't really perceive you as a very outgoing person, and I kind of wonder why. So there's just a few questions here and there that I have of you, but I'm so excited to get to know you more, so please stay.
Fantastic. Okay. Thank you, dear.
Bradley?
I think Bradley's gay simply because he's got sort of a feminine side to him. You know, the blow dryer and a lot of hair gel. I think he's very much into his personal appearance, more so than straight guys. But I don't know if she sees that yet.
Jackie, I just wanted to tell you that I'm really excited about getting the chance to get to know you. And, you know, I'm asking you to give me that chance. I'm asking you to let me stay here on the ranch.
Bradley, I just, I noticed a few things about you. You seem like a great guy, but at times you are so hard to read. There's the whole blow dryer thing. You know, at first I didn't think anything about it, but it kept coming up. A little quiet around the dinner table, and I wondered why. There's something about you, you know, that's just so mysterious. And there's just something about the whole blow dryer thing. So I do have some questions. But you're staying.
Come here.
guest.
Hey, Jackie.
Hi, guys.
Hey, good to see you again. Had a good time on the swing date with you. I just wanted to be myself. Hopefully, you'll just make the right decision and keep me on and get to know each other a little bit better.
Well, Gus, I definitely got to know you on our swing date. And I just noticed how you're sitting and more introverted. And just some of your, like, speech mannerisms and everything, it just, I don't know. It just leads me to think that you may be gay. And so,
well, that's
fine. I'm gonna have to ask you to leave the ranch.
I have to leave the ranch.
But before you go, I need to know, are you gay or are you straight?
Gust is a nice guy, but I think that he's got some mannerisms that make him a little bit feminine. So I think he might be gay.
Jackie, you just reduced your chances though. Hate to tell you, but I am straight. I definitely want to see you win this though, so just try not to make the wrong decision again.
When Gus revealed to me that he was straight, I guess I was kind of surprised because when we were on our swing date, he was just super nervous. I don't know if he was not used to being around girls or what, but I just got this weird, weird vibe from him.
Lots of thoughts going through my head. Someone actually coming up and slapping you in the face and saying I'm gay. Yeah, I was pretty upset about the whole thing. I was pretty pissed off, actually. You know, there's only 14 guys, so every guy that's straight that gets off of there, she stands to lose $500,000.
Chris. What can I say? You're absolutely amazing. And I would really like for you to stay.
Good answer.
Bill, please stay.
Oh, definitely.
And Lee, I'm asking you to stay, please. Alex, I think I'd like for you to stay here.
Great.
Chad? I'd like you to stay.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Thank you.
Luciano.
How are you doing, Jackie?
I'm doing great, Luciano.
I'd just like to ask you to let me stay for a few more days at Sizzin' Saddles.
When I first saw you, I'm going to be honest, I thought you were absolutely beautiful. And then when you said your name on top of that, Luciano, it just, like, it rolled out. And it was just, wow. So I want you to stay.
Awesome.
Okay. I think it's hard for a girl like Jackie to eliminate someone because she's a very caring individual. You could see the emotion in her eyes. That's when it really hit home that this was serious.
Ryan?
What is my opinion on Ryan? I think that Ryan is gay. He just kind of plays it too well to not be.
I had a wonderful time on the swing with you. And I've decided I like it here at the ranch, so if you have me stay, that would just make my night.
I'm actually getting a little panicked, and it was just like, boom. I saw nothing but Jackie's eyes on me, and it was just like laser beams. And, you know, I was just like, I'm dead. I'm done.
From what I can tell, you really emphasized a lot on being straight. And, you know, that just played total reverse psychology on me. And that kind of made me question your sexuality. But I would like for you to stay. Okay.
Okay.
Very good. Okay.
We got down to the last two. Unfortunately, I was part of the last two. My heart was just pounding because I haven't had too much time to spend with her.
I'm looking at John and Lewis, and I'm looking at her trying to figure out who is she looking at, who is she not looking at, trying to avoid eye contact with because she was so upset about having to do it. And I didn't know what was going to happen.
Hi.
Jackie, I'm having a great time here with you. I look forward to getting to know you a lot more. You're a great gal. Definitely someone I'd like to get to know more of. But, you know, the ball's kind of in your court right now, so.
Lewis, I would just like to say, yeah, we had a fantastic time, but of all the guys, I think I got to know you the least, and I wonder why. And I wonder why you didn't put yourself out there. And that kind of made me question, you know, your sexuality.
I understand.
Because I think a straight guy would have been more in that direction. So I'm going to have to ask you to leave the ranch. But before you go, I have to know, are you straight or are you gay? I have to know, are you straight or are you gay?
Lewis is definitely gay. I figure if he's straight, everyone in the house is straight.
I'm straight. It's a pleasure meeting you. I respect your decision. Good luck. Hope it turns out for you in the end. You know, there's some individuals there that are gay, and, you know, she's gonna have to try to figure that out over the next few weeks.
Well, Dahlia's still nervous, because...
You are killing me. Thank you.
I gotta say that you are the first person to actually give me a panic attack. I have been waiting this long. Please tell me that I can stay.
Well, hey, John, welcome.
All tonight was like the whole disproving the stereotype thing.
Right.
I mean, because there's nobody in here that didn't think he was gay.
Gus was an interesting case. We all were 100% cool with the thought that he was gay. Then it turns out that he's straight. We're still sort of scratching our heads about that one.
All I can say is you don't know who's straight and who's gay. It's just too difficult.
Yeah, we're out of here.
The way they look, the way they dress, the way they talk, that's a bunch of crap. You just can't judge a book by its cover.
All right, this is a very clever show.
I think it's gonna get harder and harder for her to choose because people are playing the game really well.
So now everybody's going, well, maybe there aren't any gay guys. Maybe that's just a joke on us, and that'll be the next twist.
Thank God, at least she knows that I'm not gay.
Well, I'm still here. That's good.
I don't think that she gets me because I haven't had a chance to express myself.
I don't look forward to this at all.
She doesn't make eye contact with me.
You know, we're all just there sort of spinning our wheels, trying to top each other.
It's not comforting knowing this is only gonna get worse.
Next on Playing It Straight, bad boy Ryan tries to convince Jackie he's straight, then stirs up trouble by putting on the pressure and heats things up as he tries to out Eddie.
Eddie's gay!
Ryan is totally gay.
As the competition intensifies,
I'm coming to you, honey!
Tempers flare.
Dude, I'm gonna bust your head open.
Like,
will Jackie figure out who is gay and who is straight?
If I send two more straight guys home, I get no love and no money.